Okay, it's capturing. Give me a minute, I need to pull up shit on my laptop. Sounds on the user's end. It should be better than my LG 430. Chance of I can actually play the game. Right, I was gonna go to this assassination mission. All right. I hope it doesn't crash. That's gonna be a pain if it does. If you're wondering what my menu music mod is, it's the Metro 2033 one. Speaking of Metro, I might actually just play Metro for YouTube sometime down the line instead of like doing Battlefield 1 or Call of Duty 1. Because I've been like on a big like post-apocalyptic Slavistan binge. Hence why I've been playing Stalker over the past couple days, and I've beaten both Last Light and 2033. I think I might actually just play Metro for my next playthrough on YouTube. Hope this doesn't have major problems with the processing, or even just loading in general. All right. She's about standard loading time. I see how long it actually takes to load the game. You stop hitting my mic like a retard. One thing I probably hate about Stalker's AI in general, especially like Go Chernobyl, is that the AI will just like run wherever it wants to go, and I have to basically babysit it. Okay. All right. Yeah, but Call of Chernobyl squad AI is probably one of the worst AI I've seen. Normally, I can't tell the difference between a good some good AI and bad AI, But call of Chernobyl's AI, you're not even just like call of Chernobyl's AI, Stalker's AI in general is really awful. Like, I have to go to the bandit base in the garbage in a minute here to kill some guy for duty. And you'll see my AI just walk right into the thing, or in the front gate, and they'll all get killed. That's why I keep grenades on myself. Disengage. The bandit's getting mauled by something over there that I don't particularly care to find out what. Oh, it's a pseudo dog, I think. But, like, I don't particularly like the AI. Like, see, you can't force him to disengage as far as I know. And watch, he's gonna walk right into that anomaly. Yeah, I just stopped caring. Okay, I'm fine with that. Come on. I want to get a vantage point up there and see if I can take some people off of the SVD I have. I can sell you. I didn't even know that the iron part of that.
Not
Isn't there another guy over here? Yeah. What's he doing?
Прикрой, креплю его!
Oh god, the AI's going in after it, really? See, this is what I mean when I say I hate the stalker AI. Oh wait, there's a bandit. Oh. Take a Saiga, but like I know that I'm going to have to take it to Gunman and Duty here at Rostock to get it fixed. That's this. That's a loner. Can't get a good shot. Alright, hold on. Back to the AK. Whoa, Sai. Where's that coming from? Oh, it's a poltergeist. Was that a 101? That's mine. Alright, I'm moving.
another.
Okay, cool. Just throw a grenade.
Magic butler!
A huge mistake by poking my head out. Alright, I think that's him dead. Nope, there's another. Oh, he's up there. My duty guy got killed. That's kind of gay. Dude's patch, what's this? The funny thing about the AI is that it just likes to pick whatever it finds. So you get situations like this. Basically, the AI is create a clusterfuck. Shotgun shells. Should I? Should I pick up the spass? Let's say the spastic build. No, I don't think I'll take the spass. This guy did. PKM. Here to shush. Got him. How you doing, man? That's 762. That's a plasma, I don't care. Is that an SVT or an AVT? Oh, it's an SVT. Okay. I didn't know they actually had the SVT. I just saw an AVT for sale at, what was the name? Whoever Duty's Trader is. That's a good dude. Is that it? Yep, yeah, I'm playing COC. I did not. Yeah, I'm playing Call of Chernobyl. playing this for, I want to say, the past 3 days. I've actually been really enjoying COC. The AI is a bit dumb. I don't actually really have that many complaints. I'm playing with Arsenal Overhaul installed. And with this. Sure, hold on. Right, can you hear me now? Yeah, can you hear me now, dude? Sound normalization, is that in OBS settings or my stalker? Because I just lowered the stalker sound effects. I assumed you were having trouble hearing my mic because the sound effects were so loud. Here, let me modify my OBS mic. It's about 55%. That should be good. 60. I just increased my OBS mic to 60. You should be able to hear me better now. Let me see if that's a setting in Stalker. Windows sound settings, right click speakers, give me a minute. Properties. Playback. Is this the volume mixer you're talking about? Hold on, let me check my headset. Advanced? No. Loudness equalization. Room correction. Low frequency protection? No. Levels. I don't see it. Maybe it's the microphone. Oh shit, what was that? Advanced. Right click the volume mixer. Choose sound devices. Okay, which version of Windows are you talking about? Like, you know what, I'm gonna do it with text. This is gonna be faster. Okay. Alright, gotcha, dude. Wait. Hold on. What? Okay, it's 60. breeki on copyright stalker music. The stalker guitar tracks. Playing like things like Metro and Stalker, if kind of maybe want to pick up guitar. Maybe. But I just feel like I don't have enough like conviction to go and pick up guitar. Yeah, I know about the guitar tracks. They're pretty good. My frame shot to basically nothing because I've noticed like the loaders and I guess clear sky have been breeding in raw stock. Sure, let me just pull this up. Hold on. That's the stock. Who gave me? Oh, to Stingray Huntsman. Okay. All right. Hold on. And let me pull up Twitch. Where's my? There we go. Difficulty. Can you send the link? Again? Oh wait, no, alright, I'm just stupid. Hold on. I could just do it with this. That's dust. No, you can't see it. Yeah, I know, with the bandit radio. Unfortunately, I can't put it in what I have. Why are they shooting each other? Oh, is it just the thing they were shooting? I understand what's being shot at. Oh, it's just one of those things. I'm not gonna waste a grenade on that. I'll let the AI handle it. But yeah, where was I? Oh yeah, I can't put bandit radio in the loop without like going and creating a playlist on YouTube. I'm just using listen on repeat with the guitar tracks in the background. And as far as I know, listen on repeat doesn't have the function to put things in like a queue. But then that would basically
You
defeat the
exist?
purpose. Also, this is really bugs me. I have a quest to turn in 3 army medkits to this guy, and I can't talk to him and turn it in. That genuinely makes me mad that I can't turn it in. There might be a debug for it, but I'm too lazy to actually go and look go looking.
Своей дорогой, сталкер.
Restart the game, it fixes. It fixes my inability to CSC bug common. Do I like specifically have to be like right in front of him to do it? Or for it to bug fix? Sorry, just pressing F5 way out of habit. Okay, let me just save that DVD. Exit to Windows. And then restart COC. COC just needs regular restarts? Okay, got you, dude. Oh, that's nice. Okay. Yeah, Stalker really looks really nice considering its age. Like, the only thing I can think of that would probably looks nicer and is even older than Stalker would probably be actually Half-Life 2. Of course, GSC had to sacrifice a lot of performance to make Stalker look as good as it does. But considering it's running mostly fine on my end, I think they've done a good job with it. And I don't know if COC did any optimization, disable music in game. I will when I can here. Disabling music, is that like the ambient music? Yeah, I know, but the stream delay. It varies between like 20 to 30 seconds. Sometimes longer, depending on the streamer's internet. All right. Still can't talk to him. Is it like a bug specifically with this character? Or is it that can apply to a lot of characters? Like, do I just need to restart right now? Or restart again? It's all new quest NPCs. Okay, so I would just need to restart again, because I think changing my settings might have caused it again. Yeah, I know CSC's buggy, so it's a lot of the game. The regular stuff.
Здорово.
Alright, it's not a big deal. Alright, you can't help me. That's not a big deal. It's only I don't even think I was actually promised that much. It's an annoying bug, but
I need
to get rid of this 870. Let's see if he has anything in stock that's not bad. By the way, do you hear my keyboard in the back, like, just in the background? That was a problem with my old mic, and I want to know if my new mic is picking it up. Because if it's picking it up, but I need to get new switches for this. Okay, you can't hear my keyboard? That's great, actually. Can't buy the EXO yet. Does he have a Sega? Yeah, the walking sound is pretty loud. Oop. I'll see if I can pick it up in the, bod. What's this loner doing right here? Oh, is he clear sky? Oh, he's clear sky. Okay. Okay, you heard it there. That's not. Box sounds, you can hear it? Okay. I forget, do I have a Nizma in here? I just call it Nizma, I've been playing too much Payday. No, I just have a Taz. Okay.
Проходи, не задерживайся.
Is that the walk sounds, you can hear it? Okay, I got you, dude.
Давай.
Okay, they don't have better shotguns in stock, that's nice. So some ammo, that's hydro shot, that's okay, that. Is that loop, is that the 338 loop? No, that's sorry. That's my Dragunov. Thank you.
чё стоишь? Давай, подходи. Как жизнь?
Actually, believe it or not, this is kind of my first time playing Stalker for an extended period of time. I've never actually played Misery. I've heard it's basic. Like, I've heard that Misery is basically pain put into virtual form. Although that might just be exaggeration. This is like my third straight day of playing Stalker. I played Shadow of Chernobyl for, I want to say, actually no, according to Steam it was about 90 minutes of Shadow of Chernobyl, and that was like over the summer last year, and the only reason I stopped was because I jumped, like something jumped me in real life. Oh yeah, I was doing one of the Sidrovich's quests, where you have to go kill the people at the loner camp that are scamming him or whatever. And one of them ended up running away and I lost him. And, so I go and chase him down and then I come back. And then he immediately starts shooting and I jump. And I had been doing some work, like in the yard, to dig up a septic tank. I was doing some yard work to dig up the septic tank in my grandparents' yard, because they had to get it cleaned and the guy was coming tomorrow. And I had basically been looking down, and it was like to the point where my left arm and the joint that connected my arm to my upper torso was getting kind of stiff, and my neck on the left side was also stiff. And so when I jumped, I feel like I injured myself, but I did feel a bunch of pain, so I just stopped playing, and then I uninstalled, and then never played it until about 3 days ago, when I said I'll just play Call of Chernobyl. Where was I going? Christian graveyard. Time over house is Chuck Cemetery. I feel like I'm familiar almost that up. I'm not gonna have enough anti-red for a truck graveyard. Feel like I've pretty much shot my arm for a couple hours. I think like after I hurt myself playing. No. The Sidrovich missions. My grandmother actually used to shoot things. Like she would be on the porch knitting, and with like a double barrel shotgun right next to her, because she and my grandfather used to hunt. And she used to sit up on the porch with a shotgun nearby, should something come running. But no, she didn't shoot at me. I basically jumped myself in Stalker and hurt myself because of the work I was doing in the yard. Oh shit, the game crashed. Alright, that's not a problem, because that happened to me with Truck Graveyard again. No, not literally getting shot, like I felt like I got hurt, basically. Did it stop? Shit, I think it stopped. Yeah, the music stopped. Hold on. Oh, hold on. There we go. Yeah, we get to load again. You'll put bandit radio on when it's basically when it's safe for me to not or tab out and not cr accidentally crash myself. At least it's not like SGM or Lost Alpha. Yeah, no, they never made Stalker stable. Yeah, that's kind of how it worked with New Vegas when I was actively playing New Vegas. I basically had to install, I think, like three or four separate mods to even get the game to run at a stable frame rate. And then that's an entirely different story with the I had to install New Vegas Anti-Crash, New Vegas 4 GB, I think there was a community patch, and then something else. Oh yeah, NuVega script extender that did enabled the other things to work. All right, shift tapping is locked for now. Yeah, that was all missing from New Vegas. The anti-crash was something I had to actually install after I had wait, like, I want to say. Shit, how many mods did I install at one time in New Vegas that warranted getting anti-crash? I want to say it was like anywhere between 60 to 100 mods I had installed for New Vegas. Oh, that's a pretty broad number. It was maybe more like 30 to 60. Yeah, 20. New Vegas was a pretty solid game when I had it. Pretty rare, I still killed. What's that? Oh, that's a pseudo giant. It actually wasn't Bethesda's fault. That was Obsidian's, and that was mostly due to time constraints. Oh, I killed it with one hit. I'm okay with this. Ooh. What's this like red tint on my screen mean? I have a feeling it has something to do with either radiation or psionics. was running overhauls. I think I was just like running like weapon mod. Yeah, the rain's really loud. Can I turn it down in leather options? No. Yeah. Cemetery is because I'm looking for stashes because I need the advanced tools. Yeah, I'll turn it down. There we go, that's better. But yeah, the only reason I'm even in here is to look for the, tools for finding tuning. Yeah, that kind of is getting excessive. Those are anomalies. Yeah. Although I think the environmental experience you're getting with COC is as part of atmosphere, as far as I know. There's like something about Stalker, and I guess Metro 2, that just puts you in there. Yeah. That's completely different to how it is in like Fallout 4. That's not range. I'm not touching that. Like hurt your ears or I don't like to carry vodka, I think, because it weighs too much. Or at least weighs too much for the general effectiveness of it and when removing radiation. And it's usually carry anti-red. And if I had the storage space, or just like the general weight capacity, like if I had like an exosuit or upgraded, what's this? PS5, I'd probably carry more vodka. In fact, I should think I already gave most of mine to gunmen. Yeah, that's a pretty good excuse for having awful aim. Carry more vodka if I had the weight, dude. Oh, it's a military.
Zdaro.
Flash. I have no idea where to find a flash. You know what? Just for you. Ooh. Thought there was a stash hidden under there. Oh, that's stupid. Dogs. Yeah, there's probably a mod that adds, some Echki and Kvass, and what are they shooting at? There's gotta be a way to get up there. Do I think I wanted this BTR? Oh, I thought that was a stash. You shock underdogs? Yeah, it was just kind of lazy. That was just the AI moving away and figuring out a better time to attack instead of just like flat out fleeing. It's good to loud noises, grenades are the best at this. Okay, I didn't know that. Does it apply to like cats and whatever those rat things are? Or is it just dogs? Probably a stash in it. I bet you a million bucks. I usually use this best 12 on striker and sagging 12. I carry an 870, although I've not been liking it as much, and I think I want to switch to the Saiga. That shotgun, the combat shotgun in GTA 4 is based off of. I think Arsenal Overhaul adds it. Is it the Vepr?
Чего тебе?
Yeah, sure. I used the AKM for a bit, but I was having like ammo problems with it, so I just switched to a 545. What is it that I have right now? AKS-74, that's what I use right now. I kind of make it a point to carry at least like 120 rounds, so I guess best to test makes it to reload. Okay. Respawn now. Then the mag. Okay. Yeah, I did use the AKM for a bit. Like I said, for some reason, everybody in the leather uses either the AK-101 or the 545 AKs. And like, I've never. I'm carrying a rifle, a shotgun, and a sniper. I guess I can put it in my thing and just do it this way. So is the descriptor for the 545 round wrong? Because I used both the AKM and the AK-74 that I have for an extended amount of time, and I noticed that they kind of have pretty much the same accuracy. Suppressors like decrease bullet velocity or increase the drop or whatever, or is it just like a damage increase? Basically, what I want to know is, do they actually do anything? Oh, there's another fact. Keep that. think I'll just put that in my stash when I get back to, Unreal, bigger bullet equals long range damage. Yeah, I know. So is that kind of why the US uses the 5.56 round instead of like a 7.62 by 39? Or 7.62 by 51? And why the Russian switch over from 7.62 to 5.45? Oh cool, the rain's fucked off, I can turn this volume back up. It's just not thundering anymore. Also, suppress anything you need, some sign of gamma, low powder, low damage, which might slow this with dull degrees of accuracy. Okay, so the suppressors don't actually do anything. And yeah, I know how suppressors work. And even then with like subsonic ammo and low powder charge and whatever else, you're still gonna be able to hear the gun working. Defend the sensors to better because ballistic defend the weight didn't make up for almost half the ammo. Okay. Is that with the US military or Russia? Because I know we've adopted the SCAR-H for, I think, SOCOM. And just, like the SEALs, I think, have it. Maybe Delta. I thought it was 545, but nearly as good. But not, yeah, I know. I've heard that 5.56 is made to wound people and not kill them, but 5.45 I think apparently packs more punch than 5.56. I keep hearing an anomaly over there. Confusing it for an incoming blowout. Can I get back up? Okay. Okay, there's just an opening right there. Much like the G3 it has, well, it really is for sniping. Okay. I know they made a specific variant of the SCAR-H. I think it was the SCAR-HSV that they built specifically to basically be a DMR. I have not found a single stash in this graveyard. Well, no, the SCAR-H's were classified like as a battle rifle instead of. I know they have specific variants of it that are for like DMR usage and whatever, but it's technically a battle rifle. It's almost 1 hour till sundown. I can actually just camp up it here. Wait, no shit, I don't have a sleeping bag. I can't actually do that. I can just go this way. Yes, Scorpion General was approached to make a single rifle that could do everything. Replace the barrel and optics, suddenly it's a sniper, reduce barrel length, and change optics, it works in close quarters. So it was an OICW? And I forget what it was. I know they made the SCAR-L, which is intended to replace like the M4 and M16, but it fell through. I know the SCAR-H was put in, but the SCAR-L was dropped entirely on its head. Oh, wow, a stash. And it's got nothing in it. Realistically do that like with an M4 or an M16 or whatever. I know they have like 7.6 or 308 versions. And similar versions. So why not just like do that with the these bandits?
Личному составу отдыхать.
This is the way back to Rostock, isn't it? That's the Tark Valley. Shit. Oh, well, might as well do a full trek. Watch me get murdered by like a million bloodsuckers. 421. I think I'll wrap it up once I head back to Rostock. I need to go to bed. Damn, this flame's loud. Is it really that loud? Might be your volume. If it's actually like loud and you get your volume set to a decent level, I'll see if I can set the thing back to level. This never sounds like one. Oh, you're just referring to the, like the general quality. Yeah, there's kind of a problem with that in this. Some of the sounds of ears playing really loud. Like the AI likes to fire their AKs right next to my ear. It's just not comfortable at all. I hear a dog. Shit. Just do a three. Yeah, I know. That's what I kind of do. I just keep my head on a constant swivel whenever I have a. I know there's a blood, at least one bloodsucker around. No, compared to my mic. I'll set my mic higher. There, it's at 70%. It should be better now. God, first generation night vision is terrible. That's a bandit, and I see two artifacts. The game lower in OBS, yes, it helped a ton. Okay. I'm going to set these guys on. Thank you. this is stalker difficulty. Both of you have like 1 HP. So it's like hard. This is loud. I'm turning this back down. I hear something. Alright, I'm just gonna do that. Change sound card settings or system sounds. Yeah, I'm just gonna type it. Alright, I've lowered the volume down to 60% for the game. Let me see if I have it in OBS. Audio. Generally connected devices.
Nope, I don't see it.
30-50% if it's on 70. Okay, I just set it that. Good now? Your mic is perfectly clear when it's in the menu. It's all static. I'll need to check the VOD. Is there an artifact here? There's not. I no longer care. Shit. Just down the road to Rostock. Alright. Radiation. I'm not touching that. So when you run into some bandits. Knowing the AI, the AI, in my experience, seems to be basically been the equivalent of the default Arma 3 AI, like without Ace 3 installed. Where it'll spot you a mile away and then just start shooting at you. I've had the luck of not being immediately headshot by the AI, but it still spots you like a mile away. The flashlight on, yes? What do you mean? Oh, yeah, well, I mean. You know what, you might actually be right. Huh. It's like a big shoot me marker. What was the other game that did that? Shit, I can't think of any game that did that. It wasn't Far Cry Blood Dragon. Not Half-Life. What was it? Oh yeah, it was Fallout. Yeah, the Fallout games had that when you turned your Pip-Boy light on.
I guess I tend to forget to turn the flashlight off in the first place and end up getting shot at.
pushing into the bat with him to basically curse it. Alright. I don't particularly care for the mama speeds. The solo's monkey is the other thing.
Ну привет!
Oh, he's got the Saiga. I'll take the Saiga. 14k.
Не балуй.
Yeah.
Оружие спрячь.
Как жизнь?
Проходи, не задерживайся.
I think I might just throw my P250 in this, the stash I have. Is there any particular reason I should carry like slugs around? Because I do feel like they're kind of a decent weight put on my weight. Like I already have a rifle and a SVD. And then 24. Oh no, that's an L115. I was actually going to use it over my SVD, but the cost of repairing it was like 50k. And the ammo, dropping ammo on it is like 4k for like 20 rounds of ammo. So I just couldn't actually just buy it. Or I could, I had it, but I couldn't repair it. I would use the L115 if I had the money to repair it, and if I had the, like, at the time, I had, like, 49k, and I was just, like, just shy of the required amount. Oh, a blowout. Alright, this is a side shelter. Recise storm. And this money will make mints of everything. I can understand that. Yeah, this is technically shelter. Like, I know how 338 Lapua can make mincemeat of everything. But the cost doesn't justify how much use I would get out of it. So that's why I'm just kind of using the Dragon off. Believe me, I would use the L115 if I could afford it and like afford to keep feeding them the thing. A bunch of people just got zombified. And now my frame rates have dropped significantly. I believe I have Psy Swarms to zombify. Yeah, I think people are just like dropping. In one Zaton can get you the improved Dragunov. He's in Gordon though. Like, I know. Y'all range rifle? Yeah, I know about Nimble. I've looked at Nimble stuff, and his stuff's like literally the cheapest thing he has is, I think, exosuits. Even as full auto, I recommend tapping fast. Why would I need a full auto dragon off? That's kind of silly. Wait, can I modify mine to have full auto? Vision device, automatic optical target, sight contrast. Basically, the only reason why I don't use a lot of like the NATO stuff is because I'm pretty much poor. Yeah, people are getting zombified. Is it over? Imagine it consumes the ammo too much to actually be considered effective, though. It's 95% as accurate while still being useful in the same place as the AK. The question is it an ammo hog, though?
Huh?
Should I just get rid of all my slugs? feel like I should. Ah, that's more Dragunov ammo. Pseudogiants are super profitable. They're so profitable, it's ridiculous. Like, I could just... how much does one grenade cost? One grenade for 13k, or 1k, or 1.3k, getting at me about 13k. It's so profitable. Maybe like 2.6. Don't sell my shell slugs. Is there a specific reason why?
Новости, сталкер.
Oh wow, and a mission too.
Ну, здорово.
Pseudogiants need slugs. As the hunters are getting controls are other nasty stuff. I saw earlier, I just chucked one grenade at a pseudogiant, instantly healed it from my GP25. Also, I like how a size army and a mission both happen within a couple seconds of each other. The biggest mutants have armor like skin. This looks at the faces, their weakness. I see. But I mean, you saw earlier, there was a pseudogiant in the truck graveyard.
Okay, no, and
I just chucked a grenade at his face and he instantly just like collapsed. Like, the most a pseudogiant can take from grenades is 2. About shooting from a GP25. Like the what's it? Fuck 25 grenades. That's why I carry them in my that was the first thing I bought from my AK, actually, the GP25, so I could shoot things. I can't check like the F1s and the RGDs to save my life, but I can shoot them fairly well. Also because the game actually does the launching calculation for me. But yeah, in case you didn't hear me over the emission, the first thing I bought for my AK was a GP25 specifically to deal with things like controllers and pseudo-giants and whatever else the game threw at me. And considering kill this pseudo-giant and one direct grenade hit, I basically feel like I don't have enough of a need or a reason to keep the slugs.
Ну, привет!
What was I doing here? Oh, yeah.
Привет, брат! Ну, привет!
And I need to throw this in the stash. But yeah, this is the L-115, and I do have the ammo for it right here. Dropped 3.9 on it, or 3.9k. Alright, dude, I need to go to sleep. I didn't actually intend the stream to go on as long as it did. I'll see you whenever I see you, dude. Bye.